For all entries, ABAP statement. The for all entries statement allows you to build an internal table and then restrict the database select to only get entries contained in it. In order to avoid nested selected statements, using the join statement, we can go for all entries. Some points to notice when using for all entries. 1. Duplicate rows are automatically removed. 2. If the internal table used in the clause is empty, all the rows in the source table will be selected. In that case, always check if it is not empty before executing the statement. The fields used in the for all entries must match the types of the fields of the database tables. Let's practice using some for all entries using the same example as of the join tables. So let's go back to our program where we used the join ABAP statement, and let's change that join for an all entries ABAP statement. So let's navigate back to our package and to our programs. We look for see joining tables program and we click on change. And now remember we had this join and then we used a database view. So now let's comment this and let's comment this also and the types. Let's try making the same program, selecting the same data, but this time using for all entries. So first of all, we have to declare our internal tables. So we declare a local table scar type table of the database table scar, and I also declare a working area using like line of my internal table. I also declare another internal table for DSP flight table and a working area for the same table. Now, first we select all the data from the SCAR table into the corresponding fields of our internal table SCAR table. So now we have all the contents of the database SCAR table in the LT SCAR internal table. Now we're going to select all the contents from the SP flea table into corresponding fields of my L local table SP flea, and then I specify for all entries in my other internal table SCAR, where the car ID from my SP flight table equals the LT SCAR car ID. So now I'm going to select all the contents from the SP flight that match this criteria, and that criteria is that matches all the car IDs from the SCAR table that we previously selected. It is important to check that our LT SCAR table is not initial, because we don't want all the data to be selected if it is initial. There you go. So we check if it is not initial, this table, and if it is not initial, we use its contents to select everything from this table. And now we need to print the content to the screen. So how do we do that? We need to loop at our tables. So let's loop at our SP flight internal table and inside we're going to write all the contents of this table, but we need the car name that is stored in the other table, so we need to join them somehow. How do we do that? Well, we use the ABAP statement read table, so we can read the car name from the other table into a working area with key. We need to specify which key of the car ID I want the name for, so I specify the car ID the same way as the current loop pass for the other internal table. So if I get a match, or if my site sub RC equals 0, then I'm going to write my contents to the screen. My con ID, my city from, and the last content I'm going to write it from the SCAR table, that is the car name. So now I look at the contents of the SP flight table, and inside the loop I read the contents of the other table using the same key, and then I write it to the screen. Let's check the syntax of our program. Let's activate. And now let's run our program to see the result. We forgot one very small detail. It is very important to always write the new line, because if not, you see what can happen. So let's activate again, and now you can see everything was printed better to the screen. So you can also use for all entries to avoid using the join statement. You should now be able to list different methods for searching relevant database tables, program read access to specific columns and rows within a particular database tables, list different methods for read accesses to several database tables, use the join ABAP statement to select data. Remember, you can join more than two tables. Use the for all entries statement to select data. remember that you can also use it for more than two tables. Sometimes the for all entries is a better use than the join ABAP statement. And you can also create a database view in the ABAP dictionary to join two or more tables.